Hey, what's up everyone? Tim here from Everyday Tactical Vids. We're about to check out two new knives that I just got from Topps. So today we're gonna talk to you about the Dicer 8 from Topps and also the Dicer 3 as well. So when I was talking to Craig from Topps at SHOT Show 2019, I said to him, hey man, I'd love to check out those knives. I haven't seen any reviews on them yet. And he was like, well, that's because they're not out yet. They're still in production. So I said, hey, when they come out, I'd love to check them out. I emailed them when I saw that they were available. And he said, yeah, let's get a review out. So, cool knives. Now, obviously these are kitchen knives. Now you could use these in the outdoors, you know, for cooking and stuff. They're not, it's not a super thick knife. It's not made for the outdoors fundamentally. It's not, you're not gonna baton with this thing. But if you're using this out in the woods for prep, you know, for different things like that, and this is a cool little just knife in general, I could see you using them for lighter use. But these are built to be kitchen knives. In my family, my wife is the better cook, and so she cooks a lot, but I'm kind of her sous chef. So I do a lot of that prep work. When we're like having tacos as a family, I'm often cutting up all the vegetables and stuff that we're gonna put on the tacos. So I'm like, yeah, I'd like to have a good knife to use or a bunch of good knives to use. I can tell you from experience, other than being out in the woods for like an extended amount of time when I'm purposely trying to use a knife or, you know, I'm putting myself in a survival scenario to test some skills. For me, the vast majority of times when I'm using knives, it's in the kitchen. I use knives more often in the kitchen than in an everyday carry scenario because like I'm cutting a couple boxes here and there during the day, a little bit of cordage maybe for something. But when I'm in the kitchen, I'm in there for, you know, 35 minutes, 45 minutes prepping a meal. I'm using knives, cutting things. I mean, every morning I make breakfast for my kids, my lunch for my daughter before she goes to school. So I'm cutting up vegetables and fruit. So that's what kind of inspired me to want to check out these two knives. I just wanted to start the video outside, but now we're going to head inside. We're going to get some footage of me using the knives. I'll give you the details on them. And I'm not going to just use them today on camera. I'm going to use them for just a longer amount of time so I have a better sense of how they work. And then I'll give you my conclusions on the Dicer 3 and the Dicer 8 from Topps. All right, so my plan was to go inside, give you all the details, but basically I went inside and it was time to make dinner. So I just got to using the knives immediately. So we're back outside. Let me give you the details on the knives and I'm gonna roll in footage throughout this video so you can actually see what the knives look like in use. So first off, let's talk about the Dicer 3. Let me just show you what it looks like up close there. Your steel for this S35VN, as well as for the other knife we're gonna talk about in a second, it's a great steel. I mean, it's a high-end steel, obviously. Your end-to-end length, 7.88 inches, and your cutting edge is 3.5 inches. We're looking at 4.7 ounces for the knife, and your blade thickness is 0.09 inches. For your handle, what you have there is black and blue G10, and then you have a black canvas micarta. That black inside there, see if you can pick that up on camera. So you've got a combination for the handles. These do come with sheaths. What I can tell you is that the sheaths are basically to carry the knife if you're out, you know, maybe if you say you're going camping or if you gotta transport the knives. They're not like a sheath that has a dangler or a sheath that's got like a belt system, because these are basically made to be transported to you, and then most people are gonna put them in like a knife block or something like that. So I can tell you that the sheaths are actually pretty nice as far as the Kydex and what it looks like. But I think like when I was talking to Craig out at Topps, you know, he's basically like, they assume most people are gonna get these and keep them in the kitchen, probably not in a Kydex sheath, but where they keep their other kitchen knives, which is exactly what I did. When I got these, I took them out of the sheaths. I put the Kydex sheaths like in a drawer, but I put them basically right into the knife lock where we keep all our other kitchen knives. Here's a look at your Kydex. The lockup is good. I mean, I'll show you, I'm holding the knife securely here. So it's not like it's flying out, you know, the Kydex is flying off. Nothing super fancy about the Kydex. It definitely gets the job done as far as if you wanted to transport this. I'd probably, if I was transporting this like out into the woods to use it for like food prep, I'd carry it like this, but then I'd wrap it in a cloth or something like that. Maybe wrap it in like a chamois scarf or something like that. So there's a look at the Dicer 3. Large size hands. These things fit nicely, and they've been great. So as you'll see as I roll in various footage here, they do a great job in the kitchen doing lots of different tasks. 3.5 inches for the blade is good for this size knife, right? So you can cut some smaller things. You're not gonna do major processing of, you know, something huge with this out in the field or, you know, even at home, like in the kitchen. But this has been a lot of fun to, use these, or use this one in particular in the kitchen. Here's the other one I've been using. This is the Dicer 8, obviously a a bigger knife. This one has honestly been more of a go-to for me just because the food I've been processing in the kitchen and prepping and stuff, I've been using a bigger knife. It's been easier for a lot of those tasks. So again, S35 VN for the steel. Same thing for the handle. You've got that black and blue G10 and then a black micarta liner in there. Excellent steel. Again, I will tell you these both came very sharp. So even as I was like picking them up or moving them around, I almost nicked my hand. So just be really careful when you get them. Here's the Kydex sheath that it goes in. Same thing as the Dicer 3. Let me just show you here. So the lockup is good. You can hear a little rattle, but again, they're not made to be carried around like on your belt. I basically put these in the drawer and then put this in the knife block as well. 0.09 inches for your thickness as well. 7.75 inches for your blade. 12.25 inches from end to end. And for both these knives, it is a tumble finish. So as you see it there, it's not like, I mean, we've got a little bit of shade from the trees here, but it's not like it's dirty. It's just that that's, you know, how the tumble finish actually looks. So price point for the two knives, if you get them together, it's $320 for the set. If you get them individually, it's $200 and $160. So you're gonna save $40 if you purchase the two knives together. So let me talk about my experience with the knives. First off, I love them. I was saying to my wife the other day, we were just catching up one night, and she was like, so, you know, what's going on? What's new? How's life, basically? And I said, you know, there's sometimes I get products, I'm like, oh, that'll be cool, but I basically committed to doing the review, so I'll do the review. There's other products and I'm like, I'm really excited about that. To be honest, there's so many knives out there. There's times where I'm kind of like, all right, it's another big fixed blade. It's another folding knife. I told her, I'm like, I am psyched to use these and to shoot a video of these. So these have been a lot of fun to use. It's actually, if you're somebody who like maybe likes to cook and then you're like, yeah, you know, if I got a good set of knives, maybe that would help me like cooking more. For me, I'm just like, yeah, let me prep lunch. Let me make dinner. Let me help out with things, because they've been just a lot of fun to use. Again, the sharpness, they come razor sharp and they have cut really well. So having a good sharp knife is important when you're in the kitchen. If you're not aware of this, whether it's outdoors or in the kitchen, a sharp knife is actually better than a dull knife, because as you're cutting, you're not trying to force the blade through something because it's dull, and then when it slips, you know, you really hurt yourself. If you're slicing with a really sharp knife and you get yourself, yeah, it's not good to cut yourself, but it's a lot less likely to be like a major slash because you're putting all this force behind it. So have your knives sharp. That's how you should have them, whether they're in the kitchen or in the outdoors. They've been great knives. S35 VN, I would say, is a pretty rare steel for a kitchen knife. These guys, Topps, made some other kitchen knives that were out probably maybe a year or two ago. And again, I saw these at SHOT Show this past year and said, I definitely want to get my hands on those. Now, when you hear the price point, I'm sure some people are going to be like, why would I spend that much? I can go to Walmart and pick up some cheap knives. I get it. I totally understand. And I say that pretty much all the time. People are like, that's too much for me. I'm like, I understand. Not everybody's got a ton of money to invest in a high-end kitchen knife. What I can tell you, though, is that it's true for a lot of different products, not just knives or outdoor things, but just products in general. If you get something you like, and you just like looking at it, you like handling it, you're more likely to use it, whether it's, you know, a canoe or, you know, a new watch or something like that, whatever it is, if you enjoy it, then you're more likely to use it. So it's definitely an investment to get one or two of these, but I can tell you, like, as soon as I picked them up, I'm like, I'm gonna enjoy cooking more and, you know, doing more prep. And I've had these for 3 weeks, 4 weeks, and I've been regularly using them and continuing to enjoy them. They both feel really solid in hand. I'll show you again that I have a large size hand and that's where my hand fits on it. You're not batoning or swinging really hard with these, so it allows you to really, you know, with the way the handle is, for me, I get my thumb up there and I'm slicing through things and I've got really good control. You want to be careful with the tip, you know, make sure you don't stab it into something and then bend it, because it is a very, very fine tip. And that's true for both of them. They both obviously have a very, very slim profile, slim tip there. If you were gonna get one of the two, I would probably be inclined to get the Dicer 8, just because you can do the big cutting and you can do also some of that small cutting with it. If you have to cut something that's really long, obviously your length of pull on this one is limited because it's only 3.5 inches. Here's a quick look at the two of them, both in their Kydex. And you know, when you test a knife, you're always testing to see, like, for a folding knife, like, they're probably all gonna cut as long as they're decently sharp. How does it deploy? How does it feel in the pocket? Is it strong? does it have serrations or not serrations? There's all those kind of details you go into. I've never reviewed a kitchen knife before, so I was like, well, how am I gonna test it to see if it kind of measures up? What I can tell you is that when I've used these knives, I've liked them. When I've used them, no hot spots, no issues, and I've done quite a bit of cutting with them. They're not built for outside. Like I said probably earlier, you're not gonna see me batoning with these knives or do anything. And that thing is locked in there solid. You're not gonna see me doing anything crazy with these knives. But if you wanna make an investment for a lifelong knife in S35VN, I think these guys are definitely worth checking out. I'll be interested to see what other kitchen knives Topps comes out with. And actually the other knives that they have made for the kitchen, I may check those out in the future too, just to contrast these ones with those ones. Pretty sure those are in 1095, so S35VN obviously is at another level when it comes to a kitchen knife or just knives in general. S35VN is going to be a more expensive steel. All right, now I want to hear from you guys. As people who like knives and like knife reviews and stuff, tell me, would you spend the money on these? Is there somebody that in your family that you're like, you know what, that person is a cook or they love cooking professionally or just, you know, at home, whatever. Yes, I would buy these for that person. Are you saying, no, I'm just going to go to Walmart and pick up some knives? Whatever it is, I want to hear your thoughts on these two knives, the Dicer 8 and the Dicer 3. From Topps. Kind of a weird thing for me to be like, I want to check out kitchen knives, but I was intrigued, I was kind of inspired, and having used them, they're awesome. They're really, really cool. So yeah, let's hear your thoughts. Let's get that conversation started in the discussion section. All right, guys, thanks as always for checking out the videos. Please subscribe to Everyday Tactical Vids and Kitchens if you haven't done so already. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, check us out on Instagram, Tumblr, and Vero as well. More videos coming soon. Take care.